So, in this bag is the old snare drum. Oh my gosh. So, in this bag is the old snare drum that was on my old drum set. I haven't seen it in like 2 years, so let's see what it looks like. So if you guys don't know, this is a sound percussion drum, 14 by 6.5, has all the hardware. The only stuff I can see was wrong with this drum. The snare wires are bent and out of place. The bottom head is completely ripped. And the bottom of the shell is kind of gone, as you can see a little bit. It maybe was made like that, but it's kind of chipped. So we are going to completely paint this drum. So we are going to be taking off this head, be taking off the snares, and we are going to completely this drum that together. So we are going to be removing the bottom head and the snares with this pearl drum key. And yeah, let's do this. By the way, this video is for hitting 20 subscribers. Even though that's not a big number, I'm still blown away of the people who joined this channel. I'm also blown away that my channel has been watched over 1,000 times. I can't believe that you guys like to watch my videos, like them, comment on them, and share it to people. And it really encourages me to make more videos for you guys to enjoy.
Tension rod.
Turns out it wasn't the last tension rod. So I have the screwdriver. I'm going to be taking out the lugs. I already did that with 5 of them. I actually have my glasses, so I will be protected and so I can see. So let's get the drone. And to know which one is which, I'm gonna be putting the screws back in so I can know which one's which.
A few moments later.
Are you recording?
Yes.
Sorry. Do you need the water?
I think I do, yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's funny. Thanks.
I'm only being nice because I'm on camera.
You might have seen her on my vlog video. Go check that out on KJOA.
He'll tag it or put it in the description box below. Isn't that what y'all YouTubers do?
Yeah.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Hours later.
Done with all the lugs. Alright, I have all the hardware off. I actually had help with the butt plate throw off. So let's unwrap this wrap. Alright guys, we're about to spray the shell. This is done. Might not see it well, but I'll show you when it's on the shelf. So let's spray! Come on! guys, here's the drum with all the hardware on it. Kind of looks like a Thomas Stark Classic drum, but look at that. That is a pretty... Wait. Let's talk about that.
The reason why you don't see a screw right there is because part of the lug broke and that's how it works.
There's the screw and that's the piece that broke.
But it's still holding it and it's working strong.
So the only thing that we have to do with this drum is to put heads on it. And I'll let you know when I get heads.
3 weeks later.
Okay, so it's been a couple of weeks and I finally got some heads. And I actually did a little research and the shell is made out of mahogany. And the drum is actually 14 by 5.5. And I'm gonna actually talk about the inside of the shell in a little bit. And where's my head? It's right there. So for the heads, I'm gonna be putting on the Remo controlled sound coded, one of my favorite snare drum heads. And for the bottom head, I'm going to put on an Evans Snare Side 300.
What?
Hold on, there's a reason why I chose Evans. So I went to Music and Arts, since this is the only snare side head that they had in stock for now. But for right now, I'm using this. And I also got some Gibraltar 16-strand snare wires. So now let's talk about the inside of the shell. So there's a little black spots in it, and that's from the spray paint. I wiped it off the best I can, and I was gonna wipe it off some more, and I thought that was kind of cool. So I left it on there just for a little design and creativity. I'll leave a link in the description of all this stuff, but for right now, let's finish the snare drum. Thank you guys for watching this video of me bringing the snare drum. I absolutely love it. The finish is incredible. Comment below, what is your favorite snare drum? The sound demo is coming out soon. Thanks for watching. Keep on drumming.